On the 15th of August, 1794, this fort was in the final day of a months-long siege between France and Austria. When the fighting finally stopped and the French took back the fort, they relayed their victorious message to this building. This is where the nascent French Republic was being led. Here's the thing, that message traveled over 120 miles in less than 2 hours. At the time, it was the fastest that people had ever communicated in the history of the world. And it was thanks to the invention of this. Connecting people, towns, cities, and countries has been one of the main challenges facing our species since the dawn of time. Building roads, taming horses, mastering sailing, all of these things took thousands of years to learn and spread. Before the internet, before the telephone, news spread slowly, even inside of a single country like France. The news of the French Revolution starting in Paris took a whole 3 days to arrive to Le Havre. For context, here's a map showing the distance between the two cities. At the time, this was one of the most important ports in the country, and yet it took that long for such important news to arrive. Nowadays, that distance can be covered in less than 3 hours. News of the revolution took sometimes over a week to get to some of the farther away areas from the capital. Before modern technology, this was the norm, and anybody who could find an edge or even slight improvement in the speed or security of communication could wager to win money, power, or favor. And that's exactly what this guy did. In the late 1700s, this guy, Claude Chappe, and his brothers decided to find a way to send messages across long distances. What they came up with was a symbol system for an optical telegraph. On top of these towers, you can see these antennas. They were controlled by a guy inside of the tower, and depending on the controller, they could craft a series of symbols. So if you're sending a message from Marseille to Paris, the first tower would begin the communication, and the last tower would compile all of the symbols and transcribe them into a message. But between the two cities, there needed to be dozens, if not hundreds, of towers that essentially acted as a giant relay network. Inside of the tower, a worker would look through binoculars at the next tower over and copy the symbols that they were creating. All of this would repeat in every single one of the towers until the message reached its destination. So, for example, this symbol means one. This one means two, and so forth. I'll explain it a little bit more later on in the video. Between 1794 and the early 1850s, this was the most advanced, mass-adopted form of communication in the world. Around 1840, this was the extent of the French optical telegraph system. Pretty much the entire country was connected, along with some major cities and areas outside of France proper. Where I'm standing now is where the Paris-Milan line used to be. According to Google Maps, walking between these two cities would take 8 days, and you'd have to traverse the Alps in some pretty harsh terrain. Say you did the whole thing by horse. Depending on if you rode a single horse or a relay, and also how hard you pushed the horse, it might take around 3 to 15 days. I'd wager that using a combination of boat, horse, and walking, then the best case scenario would be maybe just under a week to send a message. Using the Chappe Telegraph, it would take under a few hours. I find this system and its history so interesting because this technology came at a very specific moment. Think about it. There were plenty of other countries, empires, what have you, that you'd think should have created an optical telegraph. All in all, the technology is pretty analog. The Romans and Chinese had a strong culture of engineering and vast empires and populaces to look over. Yet, the closest they got to this was simple smoke and flag signals. Instead, this technology came about at a time where three major developments were occurring and intertwining. Technology was expanding rapidly. When the system was being built, advancements in engineering, chemistry, and electricity were about to make the world seem more like it does today than it did in the 18th century. Industrialization was progressing. By 1850, England, Belgium, Germany, the Netherlands, and France would see urbanization rise and factories pop up. And lastly, a global world economic system was taking shape. So while the system was important and it helped interconnect France in a way that was previously not possible, in a more broad sense, it came about just a little too late. And that's why it failed. Earlier in the video, I mentioned some basics about the Chappe system. Here's how it worked. The antennas on the towers could create a set of 92 unique symbols, each corresponding to a number. These numbers were assigned specific values, typically words or phrases. To send or receive messages, operators used a code book to decipher the communication. The first symbol indicated the page in the book, and the second symbol pointed to the line on that page. For example, if a tower sent over a message saying 110, the code book would translate it to something like hello. So each tower in the chain would receive the message and then relay it to the next tower until it reached its destination. There are clear limitations to this. Only one symbol could be sent at a time, making the system slow. At peak efficiency, it could transmit just 2 to 3 symbols per minute, meaning that messages had to be concise to remain practical. Additionally, only one message could be sent at a time through a single chain of towers. But regardless of these limitations, what killed this technology, and you might have guessed it already, was the telegraph. The other telegraph. The electric telegraph, specifically the system promoted by Samuel Morse, was the first electric communication system to gain mass adoption. Governments and businesses quickly realized the potential of near instantaneous communication, which offered advantages that the optical telegraph simply couldn't match. While the optical telegraph was faster than traveling by horse, foot, or sea, it still couldn't compete with the electric telegraph's ability to send messages through a wire in seconds. Distance was also another limitation. An optical telegraph system was confined to relatively short line-of-sight connections, making something like a cross-Atlantic route impossible. When the first transatlantic electric cable was successfully laid out in 1858, it was hailed as one of the greatest achievements of all time. Reliability was also a challenge. The optical system struggled in bad weather and was completely ineffective at night. While the electric telegraph could function regardless of time or weather conditions. But it wasn't just the technology that gave the electric telegraph an edge. It was how it integrated with another transformative innovation of the era, railroads. Railroads revolutionized how people, goods, and information moved, and telegraph lines often followed their tracks. The cleared paths and direct routes made it easier to lay telegraph wires between cities, allowing the two technologies to grow together. Railroads also served as hubs for communication, where stations became key points for sending and receiving messages. This synergy accelerated the spread of electric telegraph networks and their mass adoption. There's an amazing video by Atomic Frontier about a related subject. He goes over the system of towers that would beam radio waves across the US. These towers were revived decades after they became more or less obsolete so that stockbrokers could use them to make stock market trades. The Chappe telegraph system was also used to make money in the stock market. Between 1834 and 1836, the telegraph was hacked by two Bordeaux businessmen, the brothers Francois and Joseph Blanc, to receive information on Paris Stock Exchange annuity prices before anyone else. As the field of electromagnetism and the engineering behind it continued to evolve, the electric telegraph was made more or less obsolete by the radio and the telephone and eventually digital communication like the internet. It's impressive how fast technological innovations and mass adoptions have transformed the world, but still, the idea that a whole country was interconnected by this analog system of telegraph towers, effectively granting it the most superior form of communication that people had ever used to that point, it's one of those forgotten facts that ended up having a huge ripple effect in history.